this hand. Is this hand good enough? Kind of. It's kind of good enough, kind of not. Doesn't actually do much. It doesn't have a black source for this abrupt decay. But he's not hitting me with anything for a while. I'm gonna try it. Because we know what matchup we're facing. I would not keep this in the dark. I would 100% mull this. But now that he knows what's up, like maybe he brought in enchantment hate or graveyard hate or something, and then just buys us infinite time. So we just plow whatever creature he plays on turn one. Yeah. Yeah, I'm gonna do it now to play around Spell Pierce. He can still daze it, but whatever. If he plays a Goyf here. Okay, he went Delver. Gonna play the Mother of Ruins and Maze of Ith. Exposes Mother of Ruins to daze, but I'm not that worried about it. Yeah, having Maze and Plow just makes me a little bit resilient to Delver shenanigans, which is the main reason I kept the hand. Disfigure. Interesting. I like it. On our next turn, if we don't draw a black source for the Abrupt Decay, I'm just going to run out the Horizon Canopy instead of wasteland him. Our curve is higher than his, so I don't actually want to be wasting him aggressively in the early game. Unless I have mana producers in play. Like, if I want to turn on my Deathrite Shaman, that's a good reason to waste him, but just because I can is not a good reason. Usually, the deck with the higher curve. Oh, that's gonna make me do this every turn, huh? Yeah, usually the deck with the higher curve is the one that does not want to be wastelanding. Just a general gameplay type tip that people mess up a lot. We could waste him off of blue, though. So that's something. Yeah, that Delver's not flipping. Thought he's sure. Probably takes another reliquary here. I mean, it fixes my mana, it does everything I want it to do. Elesh Norn and the Abrupt Decay are kind of stranded, so yeah, and that's what he does. Takes the knight. This attack makes sense. Gets in a point. Oh, jeez. All right. I don't hate that. Is this good? And he knows that we have the Elesh Norn in hand. So even if these Delvers flip, we're still in very good shape this game. Oh, he flips it with Abrupt Decay? Oh, that's fine. We're actually still fine. We can respond to the Abrupt Decay by activating the Survival, and we're still in reasonable shape. So we're gonna take 7 this turn, if you include activating the Horizon Canopy. And we know he doesn't have Force of Will for the Loyal Retainers, so yeah. We're still just actually gonna win this game. Mostly because of the version of survival that we're playing. If we were playing any other build, like say with the Ooze version, it would be too many discards. We couldn't fit it in. But since we have a combo piece in our hand, and it only takes two cards, two card combo, we just actually have plenty of time. With our one activation here. He's waiting for us to activate the survival. I guess it doesn't matter who blinks first in this situation. It doesn't matter at all because we know that he has it. We both have perfect information. I think he's trying to figure out if there's a way he can stop what's about to happen, but there isn't. There is certainly not. Because I have priority after the loyal retainers resolves. So he wants to abrupt decay the survival here. And then the way that he wins the game is he top decks Liliana if he runs that card to deal with the Elishnorn. Before I can draw some creatures to buffer. Yep, Abrupt Decay, that's fine. Speaking of creatures to buffer. Loyal Retainers. Get back Elishnorn. Seems good. Then after that resolved, note that I couldn't waste him and then go to my second main to waste his blue source and get out of days that way, because Loyal Retainers is weird. You have to crack it on your first main. It's a very bizarre card. We never actually got around to casting this Abrupt Decay. We're getting the mana for it, but we still don't have the mana for it. And there's no threat to attacking with Elishnorn here. He could double disfigure it. Or I guess dismember is a thing. I think we should play around dismember. There's no reason not to. Like, you could block with Tarmogoyf, let damage happen, and then dismember it post so I wouldn't even know to use Maze of Ith. I could just tutor up a Knight of the Reliquary, which I almost like better than Chaining Benchmines. Oh, I should have. Yeah, I probably should have just Abrupt Decayed and attacked for 8, to be honest. I was a little bit focused on the Benchmine chain. Fauna Shaman, activate, discard Vengevine. Warp Decay, sure. I don't know why I cracked this now. So I think it's better to do this. So if I draw a one drop, I can cast the Vengevine from my hand and the one drop to get the Vengevine that I put in my yard for later back. All right, up a match with the survival. Card's pretty good. And to put this into perspective, that was survival against a Deathrite Shaman Abrupt Decay deck. That deck had main deck enchantment removal and main deck graveyard hate. And the survival one card enchantment combo was just too much for it. So that might be telling, but we're going to play against like some combo and stuff. So we'll see how it fares against those matchups as well.